The camera.
I am the moderator, and we will begin with Article 1, to choose by vote from the floor the necessary officers of the district. The first is the moderator. Do I hear any nominations? Dennis?
I'll nominate Frank Crozier.
Are there any other nominations?
Second.
Who's second?
Norm.
Norm.
Are there any other nominations? Second call. Last call. The moderator directs the clerk to cast one vote for Frank Crozier for moderator. The next is the clerk of the district, also elected. Are there any nominations?
I nominate Gail Timberlake.
Okay. Is there a second?
Second.
And?
Mike Rowland.
Mike Rowland. Are there any other nominations for clerk of the district? Second chance? None. The clerk is directed to cast one vote for Gail St. Hilaire for clerk. Next is treasurer of the district. Are there any nominations?
I nominate Mary Swinton.
All right, is there a second to that nomination?
Second.
Good. Are there any other nominations for treasurer of the district? Second call. Any other nominations for treasurer of the district? Hearing none, the clerk is directed to cast one vote for Jamie Brittany for treasurer. Plan commissioner to serve until the annual meeting of the district in March 2021, a three-year term. Are there any nominations?
I nominate Norm Giroux.
Norm Giroux. Normanda Giroux, yes. Is there a second?
Frank.
Are there any other nominations for commissioner of the district to serve for 3 years? Second call. Hearing none, I direct the clerk to cast one vote for Norm Giroux. Article 2, to hear reports of the district. Are there any reports of the district? Dennis, stand up and project.
Like I did.
Yeah.
I don't know where to start. Can you hear me all right? I'd like to present our outgoing commissioner, an awesome guy, and we're going to miss him greatly. He's got a wealth of knowledge and leaving us, and we can see him go. Mike LaPointe. There's no other way to describe him. I mean, he knows everything. It's just unreal. I hate him. But I'm going to give him this card.
Are there any other reports to be heard? Very well, we'll move on to Article 3. The operating budget, to see if the village district will vote to raise and appropriate the sum of, I got to put commas in there, $596,903 for general municipal operations. This article does not include appropriations contained in special or individual articles addressed separately. A majority vote is required. This was approved by the Budget Committee, and I'm sure the commissioners, right? Okay. Is there any discussion? First of all, we have to bring it forward as a motion.
Move
move Article 3.
I'm sorry, who?
I will.
Mike.
I'll move Article 3.
Check. Big bro. Who seconds the motion?
Are there any questions regarding the budget? Discussion? Comments? Yes?
So you're legal, does this include any money to?
Stand up, please.
Does this?
Here to you.
Does this include any money for future testing of residents' homes or for lead and other contaminants that might be in the water?
Mike.
The state requires certain testing. That's all included in this budget, test for state parameters.
Okay. And so with the issues that came up this past year, will the testing be increased or has the?
The state, the last couple of tests have shown no issues, so we have the state correct.
Thank you.
Any other questions, comments, issues, anything about the operating budget? Yes?
How come we have a $10,000 increase in the personal expenses?
We took on a new superintendent this year, and we're very happy with him. He's done a lot for us. And unfortunately, the cost to get somebody well-trained and good at the job was more.
What are his qualifications at this point?
He has his water too. He is a licensed electrician, and he had 6 years prior experience with the city of Dover, and he came highly recommended.
What happened to the sewer pipe? Is it water too? You saying about sewer?
He's got sewer four, water two.
He has both of those?
Yep, he's way overqualified for sewer four.
Any other comments? Yes, your name, please.
Ken Ward. How many personnel are payroll?
Two.
Two full-time, two and a half full-time. Two full-times and part-time, you pay the clerk and the treasurer.
Anything else? Don't be shy. All right, hearing no comments, questions, or issues, we will go to a vote. You will need your red card, and you will be counted. Those in favor of adopting the operating budget as previously indicated, would you please raise your red card? And I will count, because there are not that many people here.
One, two, three, four, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28.
28 votes in favor. Those opposed? No, none in opposition? Article 4, the water fund balance. To see if the district will vote to raise and appropriate the sum of $50,876 to offset the cost of water system improvements and to authorize such sum to come from fund balance with no amount to come from taxation, meaning no increase in user fees. Are there any, someone needs to bring this forward as a motion?
I will.
I second.
I'm sorry, who seconded? Ken. Yes, Ken seconded.
Mike.
What?
Mike.
Mike, sorry. He was a one day parent tax. Is there any discussion on this matter? Questions? Comments? Nope, yes.
What is the balance of that account currently?
That's unexpended funds from last year. That's part of a five-year program of water improvement. We're trying to do it without having to do a bond, so we're moving the money in by head.
Okay. So that is money that's already been set aside. Will it deplete the account completely, or will it have a little more?
Last year, that takes the remainder out of last year's budget. That's it. Includes it in the budget.
That would be the money we have.
Clem, what are we looking to accomplish this year? We've done some ice pigging on some lines, which is, you've had some discoloration in certain areas. And what happens with the old pipes is they rust internally, they're not double cement.
So do you have on Willie Street?
Yeah.
Okay. Is that going to be taken care of this year?
It might take one more year to get enough money ahead, but the ice pigging has done been a great relief to Willie Street. And when you do that process, you do it twice, you let it go for 6 or 7 months, and you do it again, you do it again, and that should clean that line out. We're going to see how it reacts. But that's what we're trying to do. We're trying to get into these problem areas without increasing the rates.
I have a question. Does the discoloration have any effect on water quality other than coloration?
As far as, not really. No.
Thank you.
Could I just make a comment that we have an incoming superintendent, Ray McNeil from Delvin. He's doing a great job with our water. And he's got, if anybody has any questions about all this, he's right on top of it. So if you guys have any questions for him, just let us know. Porter Well is probably one of the hottest ones we've got. He's right on top of that with the people worried about the arsenic. I believe everything's right back to the home. Am I right, Greg?
Yeah, we're back in compliance.
Good work.
Yep.
It's a short time for me.
Any other comments regarding this warrant article? Questions? Comments? All right, I will call for a vote. Those in favor of Article 4, please raise your red card. I'm going to do it visually this time. All right. Thank you. Put your cards down. Those opposed? Well, everybody seems to be in favor of it, so I guess I will declare it passed. Article 7, sewer fund balance. To see if the district will vote to raise and appropriate the sum of $15,828 for maintenance and repairs to the wastewater treatment plant and the collection system, and to authorize such sum to come from the fund balance with no amount to come from taxation, i.e. user fees. Who brings this motion? Who wants to make a motion to bring it forward? Julie. I need a second. Norm. Questions, comments, issues, anything? Yes.
So, Elaine, what is being repaired? Is it just general repairs, or is there something particular that is being done down there?
This is the balance from last year.
Okay.
It's coming over. You want to know what's going to happen in 2013. Maybe Ray could give us a little update on that.
Wait a minute.
Oh, he's not.
We need permission from the body to permit a non-resident to speak on technical matters. You've seen this before. Is anyone opposed to that? No? Okay. Ray, now you may speak.
Sure. So some things that we would be addressing are just general maintenance, painting, equipment replacement. There's a pump galley that's 13 years old, and it's going to be due for some replacement pumps and some advanced engineering to kind of redesign it so there's more head clearance down there. That'd be one spot to start. I would assume there'll probably be another rollover next year like there was this year. We wouldn't consume all of it. I don't see that happening, but we can't predict the future either. So with a lot of equipment and moving parts there, so that's where that type of money would go towards. I don't know if that answers the question in detail or not, but.
Well, are you satisfied with the answer?
Yes, I have a follow-up question.
Okay.
So if we're rolling money over from these two more articles here, is there ever an opportunity to reduce the rates to so that we're not having such an abundance of rollover year to year?
I can probably speak to that. We had a new plant 12 or 14 years ago, and we can't believe that this plant is going to, I guess plants, the design can last about 20 years. So we're at 12 to 14 years, and we're having more and more breakdowns. I think we just did a step screen, is that right?
We're in the process of doing the step screen,
we're
yes.
Doing a step screen upgrade. Looking at, you know, we're on the sewer side, we've got a lot of manholes that we need to do a lot of inspection with, and we've got shifting bricks and whatnot that are, if they fail, we're going to have a problem. So there's a lot that we're looking at right now, and there's a lot that we really need to get up, you know, up to snuff with. So I don't think you're going to see that go away, unfortunately. We've got a great superintendent now, and he's not going to have a problem spending that money, unfortunately, because we really need to get up to date.
So do you have a capital improvement plan that you're working off of?
Absolutely. We've got some new software that we've been working with. We've been looking at a 10-year plan. So.
Just as a point of clarification, the district doesn't have, like the town has, a set. It's different. It's out of trust fund. It's not a trust fund. It is an operating fund. Fund balance. Okay. The terms can get confusing. Any other questions? I will call for a vote. Those in favor of Article 5, please raise your cards. Those opposed? I don't see any opposition. I will declare it passed. Article 6, ordinances. To see if the district will approve additions, deletions, and or changes to the ordinances of the district as submitted by the commissioners. There are none? I am told there are none. No changes. Since there are no changes, none have to be voted upon, this article is moved. Article 7. Other business which may legally come before this meeting, which also includes, by the way, swearing in new people. Is there any matter which can come before the district meeting?
I
yes?
have a couple of questions. How close are we to reaching capacity on the sewer side? I know that there are 12 to 15 new houses off of Wentworth Road, and then there's another 18 apartments going in on Main Street. How will that affect the sewer capacity?
Most of them are Wentworth Street and not on the sewer. There's only one on Wentworth Street that's on the sewer.
Okay. So, are we close to capacity? Do we have enough room for 20 new units?
These are one bedroom apartments you're talking about, the bullets now. Yeah, we got some money.
And are we have plenty of offer to, because I know when the houses started going up, there was a lot of digging and concern in my neighborhood about the old trees coming down to make room for new water pipes to go up to Wentworth Street.
We're nowhere near capacity of water.
And the lead issues, besides testing, that is being done by individual homeowners, is there anything that your facility can offer to homeowners to help regulate the problem?
I think,
Our water is tested, and it does not contain lead. What we're trying to do is, make it as non-corrosive as possible. So the older houses with the lead solder and stuff, the problem comes in the home. And that's why there's a booklet, you can check with the state and with the water district. If you think you're in an older home, you might have an issue with your plumbing if it's not fixed or it's not done since 1940, change the plumbing code, whatever. You just run your water for 20 seconds or so in the cold water before you use it, you know, flush it. But you can always check that inside your house. You can check that with the state.
Mike, well, how many customers are there in the water facility?
We send out 557 bills, but, a lot of them are not paying it.
Right.
So it's, water, if we send out 557 bills, but there are 697 units. And sewer, there are 344, customers, but there are 470 units.
To elaborate, I get a bill for three units, but it's one building and one bill.
And we have 58 hydrants, and we have 4 sprinklers.
There is no one in the district, you may have heard about, whose grandfather who doesn't have a water meter. That cannot happen.
No, my follow-up question is, how many registered voters are allowed to vote at the sewer and water district meeting?
Anybody who is within the district.
So there's 557 bills that go out potentially, at least 557 people could attend the district meeting. And 28 people could have attended the district.
The residents can vote, not the homeowners, if they don't live here. You have to live here.
Are there any other questions? Any other matters which may come before the district's meeting? Okay, aside from swearing in new officers, that's as far, much as I know. I'm going to, as the moderator, I have the authority to swear in new people. So I have here, let's see, we're going to swear, oops. We're going to swear in a clerk, a treasurer, and one commissioner. Norm, and a clerk, and a treasurer. This is your oath of office. Okay? And I'm going to read it out loud because everybody gets the same oath of office. I state your name. Norman Giroux. Okay. Do solemnly swear or affirm that I will bear faith and true allegiance to the United States of America and the state of New Hampshire, and will support the Constitution thereof. So help me God, this I do under the pains and penalties of perjury. Further, state your name, Norman Giroux. Do solemnly and sincerely swear and affirm that I will faithfully and impartially discharge and perform all duties incumbent upon me as
Commissioner.
According to the best of my abilities, agreeable to the rules and regulations of this Constitution and law of the state of New Hampshire. So help me God, this I do under the pains and penalties of perjury. If you're willing to do that, if you would print and sign your names at the appropriate spots. Thank you.
227.
Thank you. She's actually the clerk. Now, one of the commissioners has to swear in me as a moderator. Vern Crozier.
Do solemnly swear. That I will bear faith and true allegiance to the United States of America and the state of New York. And will support the Constitution thereof. So help me God.
Yes, of course. Next part. Addition part.
I.
Vern Crozier.
Do solemnly and sincerely swear and affirm that I will faithfully and impartially discharge and perform all duties incumbent on to me as
moderator.
According to the best of my abilities, agreeing to the rules and regulations of the Constitution and law of the United States of America. So help me God.
Help me God. Okay, well, so then, I'm going to have to print one more of these things. Okay. Officers have been installed and sworn in. Is there any other comments, questions, issues?
I just had a question going on with how many sprinkler systems are there in town for the mills? And then what other buildings?
Town hall, the school, and the ones.
Any other questions? Comments? I will entertain a motion to adjourn. Clem, who seconds? Julie. All right. If there's no objection, I will ask for a vote. How many people? The motion to adjourn is before the group. Just stand up and walk out. Okay? Thank you very much for coming in. It's now 7:01.
Yes. Thank you. What's Ray McNeil, you knew, they were Craig.
So are you going to see another term, or are you going to be done after the family next year? Thank you very much.
Try to make this one helpful.